Well, you've had a very interesting debate. I sat at the back and listened to that last debate. What I didn't say in the opening remarks for you was that I am actually a farmer, as well as Vice Chairman of the International Trade Committee, sit on the agriculture, and was one of the rapporteurs on the Environment Committee on pesticides. I was very interested in what the Commission was talking about endocrine disruptors, and I think one of the gentlemen raised the situation about triazole. We did, on our farm, a huge amount of work on agrochemicals, and there has to be proper legislation on it, because I remember when BASF were doing a particular trial on one of the chemicals for a control of it, it was a weed killer. Absolutely fantastic was this weed killer. Killed absolutely everything but the crop. Marvellous product. But unfortunately, on about the sixth or seventh trial, one of the blowflies that they were using for the experiment developed an extra leg and the product disappeared. Quite rightly so, but I have to say it was very disappointing for us because we saw the prospects of that chemical. So I think, in fairness, a lot of experimental work is done to ensure that chemicals, when they reach the end person, they are absolutely correct and safe. I've just, as I said earlier on, been in Central America. And you've got to remember that the biggest killer of people in the world without any exception, is malaria. And we stopped the use of DDT. And these people were saying, why on earth did you stop it? Malaria is killing so many people now because we can't control the mosquito. So it's an interesting thought that sometimes our actions affect other people without us knowing it. I've done all the work on plant protection, and we've grown a number of specialist crops for various people. I worked with the Routes Institute on, we were the first farm to start produce beef using cereals. It was an interesting experiment at the start. We lost an awful lot of cattle through things like bloat, but never because they just couldn't cope with the cereal and the problems of it. But I learned how to use a knife into the stomach and alleviate the problem, as they might say. But situations change and move on. And as I said earlier on, with 7 million people to feed, we have a responsibility, not just as farmers, but as Europeans.